Hi friends, today we are going to discuss again from the ICAI study material, death of a partner, illustration 4. And of course it is also very simple and easy problem. So let us solve today. B and N were partners in a partnership form, and also according to the partnership deed you are given the following points: that the account books to be closed on December 31st each year, that the profits to be divided by the B 1/2, 1/2, B 1/2, okay, and 1/3, N is 1/3, which is 1/2, and of course 1/3, B as well as N. Okay, so when you want to convert, like it is like a share, you can make the denominators equal. Multiply here 3, multiply here 2. So which is 3/6 and which is 2/6. And this will be 3:2 ratio. Clear? They are sharing in 3:2 ratio because it is given 1/2 and 1/2 means 1/2 and 1/3. So when you convert into ratio, and of course the ratio will be like a 3:2 ratio. They are sharing profits losses in 3:2 ratio. Okay. So I am erasing it. So they are sharing in 3:2 ratio. And that on the event of death of a partner, his executors will be entitled the following items. One, the capital to his credit at the time of the death, whatever the capital balance he is having, and that should be transferred to his executors. Second, his proportion of profit to the death of to the date of death based on the average profits of the last 3 completed years. And you have to take the last 3 completed years and you can average, and based on that average the profit should be given from the closing date of closing balance sheet to the date of his death. Based on 3 completed years average, it should be given. And his share of goodwill also given based on the 3 years purchase of average profits for the preceding 3 completed years. And you have to last 3 years, you have to completed years, you have to take that by 3, which means you will get the average. Okay, so that is into 3 years average profit is the firm goodwill. That is a way to calculate. Okay, and how to share of profit should be given and how goodwill share should be given, both are given. If you check, it is given the balance sheet, of course it is given in the trial balance form, no problem. B's capital 90,000 and N's capital 60,000, reserve 30,000, bills receivable 50,000, investments 40,000, cash 1,10,000, and of course trade payable 20,000, total 2 lakhs and 2 lakhs. The profits of the last 3 completed years, 2013 42,000 and 14 39,000, 15 45,000, and died on May 1st 2016, because so actually books are closed on December 31st 2015. But he is alive for a period of January, February, March and April. So he is alive for 4 months period of time. For that period of time, profit also should be given based on the average profits of the last 3 completed years. Okay. So first, we need to work out share of profit for 4 months period. Second, share of goodwill. And third, simply N's executor's account to be opened. And very simple to work out. There are 2 working note points we need to finish, and later we can come to the N's executor's account. So first I would like to give the profit for 4 months period from the date of January 1st to and May 1st. So January, February, March and April, 4 months profit should be given based on the 3 completed years average profit. It should be given. Let us take the 3 completed year profits given like this. Let us say 2013, 2014 and 2015. Last 3 completed profits are given to you like this: 42,000, 39,000 and of course 45,000. That's all. These are the three completed year profits. And if you go for total of this, all the 3 years, and it would be 1,26,000. 1,26,000 by 3. You have to average it. And of course, it should be 42,000. Average profit is 42,000. And that should be considered as yearly profit. Then let us come to know the nth share of profit is equal to 42,000 is a yearly profit. But of course, I would like to give you only 4 months, that is 4/12 into, and his share should be given, and his share is 3:2, M and N. And of course, N's share is 2/5. 42,000 is the average profit, yearly profit. Out of that, this is yearly profit. So we should give only 4 months profit, 4/12. And his share is 2/5. Out of 4 months, 2/5 should be given. And of course, that profit will be 5,600. So for which you can write the entry simply P&L suspense account debtor to N's executor's account for 5,600. Okay, and that is the way the share of profit for 4 months should be given, 5,600 rupees to be given. And next point is goodwill. Again, you need to take the average of the last 2013, 2014, 2015. Of course, the profits are same, 42,000, 39,000, 45,000, and the total would be 1,26,000. 1,26,000 by 3 into 3. That is a firm goodwill, which is 1,26,000. Firm goodwill is 1,26,000. Out of that, N's share of goodwill is equal to 1,26,000 is the firm goodwill. Out of that, his share is 2/5. So 2/5 in the sense 50,400. So for 4 months, we should give the profit of 5,600. And for goodwill share should be given as a 50,400. That's all. And now let us work out, and whatever the amounts to be given, and all they should be transferred to his executor's account. First, I would like to transfer. So by N's capital balance should be transferred to N's executor's account. So, and it looks like N's capital is 60,000. Okay, and moreover, let us give both those items. Moreover, reserve is also there, and 30,000, and out of reserve, and 2/5 share should be given. By reserve, 30,000 into 2/5, that is 12,000. And obviously, in case of death, his share of goodwill should be credited, and the same should be debited to the remaining partners in gaining ratio. Of course, there is only one partner, and that is what, the M. So M's capital account debtor to N's capital account, in the N's capital by M's capital account. And this is what share of goodwill 50,400. And of course, M and N, it is B and N. Okay, here we can say it is B, and of course here also we can say B, not M and N. So here B as well as N, right? Okay, we can give the share of profit for 4 months by P&L suspense account share of profit. Share of profit, that is 5,600. And whatever the amount should be given, all of that amount should be transferred to his executor's account. to N's executor's loan account. Look at the credit total, 1,28,000. 1,28,000. So whatever the amount should be given, and all that amount should be transferred to his executor's account, and of course it is 1,28,000. Right? Okay, so that's all. This is a simple way to solve this sum, and we can discuss the practical questions in the next class. Okay, right.